Welcome to the Plan B channel, where we provide updated, accurate, and unbiased information about HIV treatment, whether you've just been diagnosed or whether you've been on treatment for a while. I'm Ben Plumley. I'm a global health strategist and advocate, and I'm passionate about getting the right information to people with HIV so they can make treatment decisions that will allow them to live long, healthy lives. In this short episode, we are going to be covering the difference between two HIV drugs, TDF and TAF, TAF. And I'm joined by Dr. Royce Lynn, who is an HIV specialist from the United States and is associate clinical professor at the University of California in San Francisco. Dr. Lynn, welcome to Plan B.
Thank you very much, Ben. Hello, everyone.
Now, some of our patients are asking us, what is the difference between TDF and TAF? Could you explain that for us?
Yes. So TDF and TAF are both a type of compound we call tenofovir. And tenofovir is a NRTI, nucleotide reverse transcriptase inhibitor. And this is the backbone of HIV treatment. So tenofovir, whether it's TDF or TAF, is one of the most commonly prescribed NRTIs in our treatment regimen combination available. So both forms of tenofovir are highly effective against HIV. The main difference between the two of them is that TDF was developed earlier, and TAF was only more recently available on the market. The older version of tenofovir, TDF, has been associated with a somewhat higher risk of renal insufficiency and bone loss. So that is one of the limitations. Not everybody develops those problems. In fact, many people don't. But TAF has the advantage of having less association with kidney or bone toxicity. So that's the main difference, but you can use them interchangeably in that they both act against HIV in the same way. You just be sure to remember that there's two other drugs that we always have to also consider, because tenofovir, whether it's TDF or TAF, is only generally one out of three drugs in your combination regimen.
So if a patient had been on a TAF-containing regimen and then got, let's say, another 3 months supply of a TDF-containing regimen, your advice would be to really check the other components of the regimen to make sure they're the same. Is that right?
That is absolutely correct, yes. So, for example, if somebody was taking a combination of bictegravir, FTC, and TAF, and for some reason they're not able to get the TAF, it is possible to just, you want to keep the other two the same. So bictegravir the same, FTC the same, but instead of TDF or instead of TAF, you can replace that with TDF.
Lovely. Well, thank you very much, Dr. Lynn.
Thank you.
That's it for this episode. In a moment, you will see information coming up on the screen telling you about how to connect with treatment information in your country and links connecting you to us. We would love to know your thoughts and any questions that you have. Thanks for watching.